Hi everyone, my name's Wolver Leader, and in this video we're going to take a look at the pub sub building block in Dapr. Now pub sub is a pretty common pattern for messaging. By using pub sub, we can enable microservices to communicate with each other using messages for event-driven workloads. The producer or publisher writes a message to the input channel and then sends that message to the topic, unaware of which application is going to receive that message. The consumer or subscriber will subscribe to the topic and receives messages from an output channel, unaware of which service actually produced those messages. A message broker will act as the intermediary and copies each message from a publisher's input channel to an output channel for all subscribers interested in that message. This pattern is useful because it enables us to decouple microservices from one another. Now, PubSub capabilities are available in Dapr as a building block. It provides a platform-agnostic API to send and receive messages with at least once message delivery guarantee that integrates with various message brokers and queuing systems. So no matter if you're using a message broker like Kafka, Azure Service Bus, or Redis, this can be pluggable and configured as a Dapr PubSub component at runtime, removing the dependency from your service that makes it more portable and flexible to change. Your service will make a network call to the Dapr PubSub building block API, and the building block API will make a call into a Dapr PubSub component that uses a specific message broker. To receive messages on a topic, Dapr will subscribe to the PubSub component on your behalf of your service with a topic and delivers a message to an endpoint on your service when messages arrive. So now that we know a little bit about what the PubSub pattern is and how the PubSub building block in Dapr works, let's see how it works in action. Okay, so here I am in Visual Studio Code, and to see Dapr PubSub in action, I've got two ASP.NET Core web APIs, one to handle the publishing of a bookshop order message and another to subscribe to the topic that our orders are going to be sent to, so they can receive the message. Now, I've got all this code available on my GitHub, and I'll put a link to it in the description below. But the first thing I want to take a look at is the order object. So in this common project, I just have a simple class that represents an order for a book. So very simple, order ID, title, author, price, nothing too glamorous going on here. Now for my publisher, let me open up the publisher, open up controllers, and then open up order publisher controller. So let's break this down a little bit. I'm injecting the Dapr client into the controller service since we'll be using it to publish our event. And I've got a single method called create order, which is going to be invoked when we make a post request, hence the attribute there. We'll need to pass a order request to the payload to the endpoint, which is going to invoke this method, publish event async method. And in this method, we're going to pass three parameters. So we've got the order pub sub, and that is going to be the name of our pub sub component. We've got orders topic, which by the very name of it is going to be the name of our topic. And then this order object is going to be the payload that we send to our orders topic. If I open up the program.cs file, you can see here that I'm adding the Dapr client service into our service container like so. Very straightforward. Now I'm going to take a look at the subscriber. So I'm going to open up bookshop.subscriber, go into controllers, and open the order subscriber controller. Now here, I'm not injecting a Dapr client into this controller. Instead, what I'm doing is I'm annotating the order received message with the Dapr.topic attribute. This attribute accepts two arguments. So the name of our PubSub component that the subscriber will target, so order PubSub, and the name of the topic that it's going to subscribe to, so the orders topic. This method will expect to receive an order object, and once the method is invoked, and once the message is received, we will log out the order that has been received and return a 200 response. Now let's take a look at our program.cs file for our subscriber. Here, I'm integrating Dapr into the MVC pipeline in this line, builder.services.addcontroller.addDapr. And on the line, at line 12 for app use cloud events, I'm adding cloud events middleware into the ASP.NET middleware pipeline. This will unwrap requests that use the cloud events structured format, so the receiving method can read the event once that payload is sent directly. And then on the line 14, app map subscriber handler, this will make the endpoint Dapr/subscribe available for the consumer, so it responds and returns the available subscription. When that endpoint is called, it's going to find all the web API actions decorated with the Dapr.topic attribute and will tell Dapr to create subscriptions for them. Now let's take a look at the component. We're going to need to set up a pub sub component. This is a simple YAML file. And for my message broker, I'm going to be using the Redis container that's initialized when we initialize Dapr. So here I'm specifying the type pubsub.redis, and then I'm providing some metadata. So the Redis host and also the Redis password. This metadata with the name order pubsub is the name of our component. So if we go back into our controllers, order pubsub, it's essentially saying, use this order pub sub component for my pub sub capabilities. Now let's test it out. So if I open up my publisher and my launch settings, I'm going to be running my publisher on host 5105 and in my subscriber 5178. So what I've got is I've got two terminals. Let me just open them up and let me just get some real estate going. Fantastic. So for my publisher, I'm going to run the following Dapr command. So Dapr run, I'm giving it an app ID of bookshop publisher, exposing it on the app port defined in the launch settings. I'm exposing it on Dapr's HTTP port of 3500. And I'm using the components folder that I defined earlier in my project directory, so I can use my Redis pub/sub Dapr component. To run my subscriber, I'm essentially doing the same thing. So I'm giving my application an ID of bookshop subscriber, exposing it on the port that's defined in the launch settings. This time I'm exposing it on the Dapr HTTP port 3502, using the components folder that I showed you earlier that defines my pub/sub component. And then I'm running my application with .NET run. So I'm going to run my publisher and then I'm going to run my subscriber. And there we go. So both my APIs are running. So to test this, I need to send a post request to our publisher endpoint, so it's going to send a message to our topic. And for this, I'm going to use Postman. Let me just get Postman on the screen. So here's a message that I sent earlier just to test it out, and it was okay. So let's see if it works in the real live demo. Here we're going to make a post request to localhost 5105 API orders. So this is the endpoint for our publisher. And we're going to send a JSON payload of our order, for our book order, sorry, that I showed you earlier. And I'm going to press send. So it looks okay here. And as I can see, my publisher has published the order, so with the order ID 1. And my subscriber has received that order, War and Peace by Leo Tolstoy. So that's a very basic example, of how PubSub works in Dapr using ASP.NET Core Web APIs. Let's wrap this up. So that wraps up this video. In this video, we learned how the PubSub building block works in Dapr, and then we saw it in action by using two C# applications that were able to send and receive messages to each other using a Redis PubSub component. In the next video, we're going to take a look at this state management building block and how we can use it to build stateful, long-running applications that save and retrieve their state. So if you like this video, give it a like. If you have any questions, please ask in the comment section below. And if you want to see more videos on Dapr, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and I'll see you all next time.